Hello friends, welcome to our YouTube channel. We have come up with special MCQ series based on a competitive book of agriculture by Nemrat Sunda. We'll come up with more subject-wise MCQ series from this book. This is part 8 and today we'll cover MCQs from agronomy topic. So without wasting our time, let's start the video. Question number 1. Hardiness of wheat grain is determined using... The options are durometer, Borlaug index, Perling index or specific gravity index. The correct answer is option C, Perling index. So, hardiness of wheat grain is determined using Perling index. Question number 2. Mutant varieties of wheat are dash. The options are Sharbati Sonora, Pusa Lerma, Kalyan Sona or both A and B. The correct answer is option D, both A and B. So, mutant varieties of wheat are both Sharbati Sonora and Pusa Lerma. So, Sharbati Sonora is developed from Sonar 64 and Pusa Lerma is developed from Lerma Rojo 64A. Question number 3. Which among the following is called emmer wheat? The options are Triticum durum, Triticum dicocum, Triticum estivum or Triticum spherococcum. The correct answer is option B, Triticum dicocum. So, Triticum dicocum among the following is called as emmer wheat. Let's know more about the wheat species. So, the botanical name for common Mexican bread wheat is Triticum estivum. The botanical name for macaroni wheat is Triticum durum. The botanical name for emmer wheat is Triticum dicocum. And the botanical name for Indian dwarf wheat is Triticum spherococcum. Question number 4. Which of the following wheat species is used for preparation of South Indian dish upama? The options are macaroni wheat, emmer wheat, bread wheat or both B and C. The correct answer is option B, emmer wheat. So, emmer wheat among the following is the wheat species which is used for the preparation of South Indian dish upama. Whereas macaroni wheat is used for suji or rava preparation and bread wheat is used for chapati and bakery products. Question number 5. Diploid species of wheat is or are dash. The options are Triticum estivum and Triticum spherococcum, Triticum estivum and Triticum vulgare, Triticum monococcum or Triticum agiloploid, or Triticum dicocum and Triticum durum. The correct answer is option C, Triticum monococcum and Triticum agiloploid. So, diploid species of wheat are Triticum monococcum and Triticum agiloploid, whereas the hexaploid species of wheat are Triticum estivum and Triticum spherococcum. The hexaploid species again are Triticum estivum and Triticum vulgare, whereas tetraploid species of wheat are Triticum dicocum and Triticum durum. Question number 6. Subsurface drainage by digging wells is called dash. The options are till drainage, mole drainage, vertical drainage or none of the above. The correct answer is option C, vertical drainage. So, subsurface drainage by digging wells is called vertical drainage. It is practiced in coffee gardens, whereas mole drainage is suitable for clay soil. Question number 7. Jointing stage of wheat comes dash days after sowing. The options are 100 to 105, 40 to 45, 60 to 65 or 80 to 85. The correct answer is option C, 60 to 65. So, jointing stage of wheat comes 60 to 65 days after sowing. Let's know more about the wheat growing stages. So, CRI stage occurs 21 days after sowing. Tillering stage occurs 40 to 45 days after sowing. Jointing stage occurs 60 to 65 days after sowing. Flowering stage occurs 80 to 85 days after sowing. Milking stage occurs 100 to 105 days after sowing. And dough stage occurs 115 to 120 days after sowing. Question number 8. The concept of permanent wilting point PWP is proposed by Dash in 1912. The options are Weymeyer and Hendrickson, Schofield, Briggs and Shands or SPL Sorensen. The correct answer is option C, Briggs and Shands. So the concept of permanent wilting point is proposed by Briggs and Shands in the year 1912. Whereas Weymeyer and Hendrickson gave the available water concept and Schofield gave the PF value concept and SPL Sorensen gave the pH value concept. Question number 9. If two irrigations are available for wheat, it is preferred at dash. The options are CRI and tillering, CRI and jointing, CRI and dough stage, or CRI and flowering. The correct answer is option D, CRI and flowering. So if two irrigations are available for wheat, it is preferred at CRI and flowering stage. Question number 10. Critical period of weed competition in wheat is dash days after sowing. The options are 10 to 20, 30 to 40, 40 to 50, or 50 to 60. The correct answer is option B, 30 to 40. So critical period of weed competition in wheat is 30 to 40 days after sowing. Question number 11. Absolute weed of wheat is dash. The options are Phalaris minor, Chenopodium album, Convolvulus arvensis, or both A and B. The correct answer is option B, Chenopodium album. So absolute weed of wheat is Chenopodium album, whereas Phalaris minor is the mimicry weed of wheat and Convolvulus arvensis is the objectional weed of wheat. Question number 12. Dash is used as blood purifier and germinated seeds are recommended to cure scurvy disease. The options are soybean, chickpea, pigeon pea, or mung bean. The correct answer is option B, chickpea. So chickpea is used as blood purifier and germinated seeds are recommended to cure scurvy disease. Question number 13. Export quality of wheat is affected by which disease? The options are loose smut, kernel bunt, rust, or powdery mildew. The correct answer is option B, kernel bunt. So export quality of wheat is affected by kernel bunt disease. Question number 14. Mustard is intercropped with wheat in the ratio of 9:1. It is an example of which type of intercropping? The options are additive series intercropping, replacement series intercropping, sequential cropping, or relay cropping. The correct answer is option B, replacement series intercropping. So mustard is intercropped with wheat in the ratio of 9:1, and it is an example of replacement series intercropping, whereas additive series intercropping is seen in sugarcane and potato. Question number 15. Rice field submergence in dash deep water during the reproductive and grain formation stages is beneficial. The options are 5 mm, 10 mm, 10 cm, or 5 cm. The correct answer is option D, 5 cm. So rice field submergence in 5 cm deep water during the reproductive and grain formation stages is beneficial. Question number 16. The rice grain or caryopsis is tightly enclosed by lemma and palea, collectively called as dash. The options are holm, culm, hull, or panicle. The correct answer is option C, hull. So the rice grain or caryopsis is tightly enclosed by lemma and palea, collectively called as hull, whereas rice stem is called as holm or culm, and panicle is the rice inflorescence. Question number 17. Which of the following is used in production of malt? The options are sorghum, barley, bajra, or ragi. The correct answer is option B, barley. So barley among the following is used in the production of malt. Question number 18. The first dwarf variety of rice developed in the world is dash. The options are IR8, TN1, Jaya, or PRH10. The correct answer is option B, TN1. So the first dwarf variety of rice developed in the world is TN1. Whereas IR8, it is the first high yielding dwarf variety in the world. Jaya, it is the first Indian high yielding semi dwarf variety. And PRH10 is the first hybrid of basmati in the world. Question number 19. In SRI system, transplanting of young seedlings are done at dash leaf stage. The options are 2, 4, 6, or 10 to 12. The correct answer is option A, 2. So in SRI system, transplanting of young seedlings are done at 2 leaf stage. Question number 20. The most ideal weather condition for wheat at grain formation stage is dash. The options are cool and moist, hot and humid, warm and humid, or warm and dry. The correct answer is option D, warm and dry. So the most ideal weather condition for wheat at grain formation stage is warm and dry, whereas cool and moist, it is ideal at vegetative growth period. Question number 21. Mexican wheat varieties were dash colored grains, while Indian and its cross are dash colored. The options are amber brown, red amber, red brown, or amber red. The correct answer is option B, red amber. So Mexican wheat varieties were red colored grains, while Indian and its cross are amber colored. क्वेश्चन नंबर 22, व्हाट इज द सीड रेट ऑफ वीट बाय डिबलिंग मेथड? द ऑप्शंस आर 100 केजी पर हेक्टर, 125 केजी पर हेक्टर, 25 टू 30 केजी पर हेक्टर और 35 टू 55 केजी पर हेक्टर. द करेक्ट आंसर इज ऑप्शन सी, 25 टू 30 केजी पर हेक्टर. सो 25 टू 30 केजी पर हेक्टर इज द सीड रेट ऑफ वीट बाय डिबलिंग मेथड, वेयर एज 100 केजी पर हेक्टर इज द सीड रेट ऑफ वीट बाय नॉर्मल सोइंग एंड 125 केजी पर हेक्टर इज द सीड रेट फॉर लेट और ब्रॉडकास्टिंग मेथड. क्वेश्चन नंबर 23, द डबल क्रॉस टेक्निक फॉर हाइब्रिड सीड प्रोडक्शन इन मेज वॉज डेवलप्ड बाय डैश. द ऑप्शंस आर एल्बर्ट ब्राउन, ईएम ईस्ट एंड जी एच शल और डी एफ जोन्स. द करेक्ट आंसर इज ऑप्शन डी, डी एफ जोन्स. सो द डबल क्रॉस टेक्निक फॉर हाइब्रिड सीड प्रोडक्शन इन मेज वॉज डेवलप्ड बाय डी एफ जोन्स, वेयर एज द सिंगल क्रॉस टेक्निक फॉर इन मेज वॉज डेवलप्ड बाय ईएम East and G.H. Shull. Question number 24. Depth of sowing is depend upon the length of coleoptile. What is an average depth ideal for wheat sowing? The options are 3 to 4 cm, 4 to 5 cm, 5 to 6 cm or 5 cm. The correct answer is option D, 5 cm. So, depth of sowing depends upon the length of the coleoptile. The average depth ideal for wheat sowing is 5 cm, whereas 3 to 4 cm is ideal for triple gene dwarf varieties, 4 to 5 cm is ideal for double gene dwarf varieties, 5 to 6 cm is ideal for single gene dwarf varieties. Question number 25, which of the following is known as flint corn? The options are Zia maize indentata, Zia maize indurata, Zia maize averta or Zia maize amyliacea. The correct answer is option B, Zia maize indurata. So, Zia maize indurata is known as flint corn. Let's know more about the classification of the maize. So, the botanical name for dent corn is Zia maize indentata. The botanical name for flint corn is Zia maize indurata. The botanical name for sweet corn is Zia maize saccharata. The botanical name for flour or soft corn is Zia maize amyliacea. The botanical name for popcorn is Zia maize averta. The botanical name for waxy corn is Zia maize serratina. The botanical name for pod corn is Zia maize tunicata. Question number 26. Commonly cultivated maize in India is dash. The options are popcorn, flint corn, flower corn or dent corn. The correct answer is option B, flint corn. So commonly cultivated maize in India is flint corn, whereas dent corn is extensively grown in USA. Question number 27. Moisture content at harvesting stage in wheat is dash. The options are 8-12%, 12-16%, 18-24% or 25-30%. The correct answer is option D, 25-30%. So moisture content at harvesting stage in wheat is 25-30%, whereas 8-12% is the moisture content for safe storage moisture of wheat. Question number 28. The mostly cultivated 6-rowed barley group in India is dash. The options are Hodium vulgare, Hodium irregulare, Hodium distichon or both A and B. The correct answer is option A, Hodium vulgare. So the mostly cultivated 6-rowed barley group in India is Hodium vulgare, whereas Hodium distichon is the 2-rowed barley. Question number 29. If maize is sown in dash direction, it helps to augment the grain productivity due to greater availability of light. The options are south to north, east to west, north to east or south to east. The correct answer is option B, east to west. So if maize is sown in east to west direction, it helps to augment the grain productivity due to greater availability of light. Question number 30. Seed rate of hybrid maize is dash. The options are 20 to 25 kilogram per hectare, 18 to 20 kg per hectare, 40 to 50 kg per hectare or none of these. The correct answer is option A, 20 to 25 kg per hectare. So seed rate of hybrid maize is 20 to 25 kg per hectare, whereas seed rate for composite varieties is 18 to 20 kg per hectare and seed rate for fodder purpose maize is 40 to 50 kg per hectare. Question number 31. In maize for moisture and nutrients, point of view critical period is dash. The options are silking stage, tasseling stage, period between tasseling and silking stage, or seedling stage. The correct answer is option C, period between tasseling and silking stage. So in maize, for moisture and nutrients point of view, critical period is the period between tasseling and silking stage. Question number 32. Among the cereals, highest quantity of minerals are found in which crop? The options are sorghum, wheat, barley, or pearl millet. The correct answer is option D, pearl millet. So among the cereals, the highest quantity of minerals are found in pearl millet crop. Question number 33. Among the cereals, water requirement is lowest in dash. The options are sorghum, maize, barley, or pearl millet. The correct answer is option D, pearl millet. So among the cereals, the water requirement is lowest in pearl millet. It is also the highest drought tolerant crop among the cereals as well. Question number 34. Seed rate of bajra for transplanting is dash. The options are 3 to 4 kg per hectare, 4 to 5 kg per hectare, 2 kg per hectare, or 1 to 2 kg per hectare. The correct answer is option C, 2 kg per hectare. So seed rate of bajra for transplanting is 2 kg per hectare, whereas for direct sowing the seed rate is 4 to 5 kg per hectare. Question number 35. Male sterile variety of sorghum is dash. The options are combined Kafir 60, Pusa Cherry and SSG 58-8, Tift 23A1 or CSH9. The correct answer is option A, combined Kafir 60. So male sterile variety of sorghum is combined Kafir 60, whereas the multicut varieties are Pusa Cherry and SSG 58-8. The male sterile line of pearl millet is Tift 23A1 and CSH9 is the salinated tolerant variety of sorghum. Question number 36. The toxic limit of HCN in sorghum is dash. The options are 300 ppm, 200 ppm, 100 ppm or 50 ppm. The correct answer is option B, 200 ppm. So toxic limit of HCN in sorghum is 200 ppm. Question number 37. Bajra is also known as dash. The options are cattail millet, candle millet, dark millet and spiked millet or all of these. The correct answer is option D, all of these. So bajra is also known as cattail millet, also known as candle millet, also known as dark millet and spiked millet. Question number 38. What is the chromosome number of Indian sugarcane? The options are 2N is equal to 80, 2N is equal to 82 to 124, 2N is equal to 118 or 2N is equal to 88. The correct answer is option B, 2N is equal to 82 to 124. So 2N is equal to 82 to 124 is the chromosome number of Indian sugarcane. Let's know more about the sugarcane species. So the botanical name for noble cane is Saccharum officinarum and the chromosome number being 2N is equal to 80. The botanical name for Indian cane is Saccharum barberi and the chromosome number being 2N is equal to 82 to 124. The botanical name for Chinese cane is Saccharum sinensis and the chromosome number is 2N is equal to 118. Question number 39. Which of the following is wild species of sugarcane having very high fiber content? The options are Saccharum officinarum, Saccharum spontaneum, Saccharum barberi or Saccharum sinensis. The correct answer is option B, Saccharum spontaneum. So Saccharum spontaneum among the following is the wild species of sugarcane having very high fiber content. Question number 40. Sugarcane planting done in June, July is called dash. The options are autumn planting, aksali or spring planting, atsali planting or none of the above. The correct answer is option C, atsali planting. So sugarcane planting is done in June, July is called atsali planting, whereas autumn planting is done in the month of October and aksali or spring planting is done in the month of January to February. Question number 41. Which of the following is most common method of irrigation in sugarcane? The options are flood irrigation, check basin, furrow method or drip irrigation. The correct answer is option C, furrow method. So furrow method among the following is most common method of irrigation in sugar cane. Question number 42. Sour taste of gram leaf is due to the presence of dash. The options are malic acid, oxalic acid, ascorbic acid or both A and B. The correct answer is option D, both A and B. So sour taste of gram leaf is due to the presence of both malic and oxalic acid. Question number 43. Which of the following crop is highly susceptible to frost at flowering stage? The options are pigeon pea, gram, green pea or cowpea. The correct answer is option B, gram. So gram among the following crop is highly susceptible to frost at flowering stage. Question number 44. The sowing depth of gram in order to escape wilt disease is dash. The options are 4 to 5 centimeter, 10 to 12 centimeter, 8 to 10 centimeter or 2 to 3 centimeter. The correct answer is option C, 8 to 10 centimeter. So the sowing depth of gram in order to escape wilt disease is 8 to 10 centimeter. Question number 45, wilt resistant variety of gram is dash. The options are Avrodhi, Gaurav, RS11 or Aparna. The correct answer is option A, Avrodhi. So wilt resistant variety of gram is Avrodhi, whereas Gaurav is the variety which is resistant to Ascochyta blight. RS11 is the mutant variety and Aparna is the variety where grains remain in green in color. Question number 46, nipping that is practiced in gram is done using dash. The options are triiodobenzoic acid, NAA, auxin or GA3. The correct answer is option A, triiodobenzoic acid. So nipping that is practiced in gram is done using triiodobenzoic acid. Question number 47, in sugarcane, the formative phases of growth requires maximum requirement of water. This phase comes after dash days after planting. The options are 60 to 80, 80 to 100, 60 to 130 or 130 to 160. The correct answer is option C, 60 to 130. So in sugarcane, the formative phase of growth requires maximum requirement of water. This phase comes after 60 to 130 days after planting. Let's know more about the irrigation stages in sugarcane. So the germination growth phase ranges from 0 to 60 days after planting. The formative growth phase ranges from 60 to 130 days after planting. The grand growth phase ranges from 130 to 250 days after planting. And the maturity phase ranges from 250 to 365 days after planting. Question number 48. Crop lodging is the falling down of crop due to dash. The options are strong wind, flooding, both A and B or none of these. The correct answer is option A, strong wind. So crop lodging is the falling down of crop due to strong wind, whereas water lodging is falling down of crop due to flooding. Question number 49, byproduct of sugarcane containing lime and used for reclamation of acidic soils is dash. The options are bagasse, molasse, press mud or both B and C. The correct answer is option C, press mud. Of sugarcane containing lime and used for reclamation of acidic soils is press mud, whereas bagasse is used for fuel and paper making. Molasse is used for alcohol production. Question number 50. Earthing in sugarcane is important practice in Maharashtra. Earthing in sugarcane is done in dash. The options are June to July, August, Jan to Feb or March to April. The correct answer is option A, June to July. So earthing in sugarcane is important practice in Maharashtra and earthing in sugarcane is done in June to July. Whereas in the month of August, the tying in sugarcane is done. That was all. Thank you friends for watching our video. Hope you find it useful. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel for more such videos. Thank you.